You gentlemen can watch while I'm scrubbing the floors, and I'm scrubbing the floors while you are gawking. And that maybe once you adopted me, and it makes you adopt feel swell on a ratty waterfront in a ratty old hotel. And there y'all ain't never adjust to who you're talking. You never adjust to who you're talking. Suddenly one night, there's a scream in the night, and you wonder, what could that day be? And you see me kinda grinning while I'm scrubbing, and you wonder, what's he got a grin? In a ship. A black freighter. With a skull on his masthead. Will be coming in.
A series about a bunch of gorillas?
Second. Want some rye?
Of course you do.
Thank you. I'm almost done with my shitty image. Give me 3 more seconds. Don't make any fucking wishes. You're gonna be like, oh, I didn't finish doing my thing. And I'm gonna be like, I told you that the song wasn't supposed to happen, but Photoshop's running slowly because I have so many programs running. Gee, I wondered why, Noel. Fucking moron. That's okay, though. It's okay, though. I'm so smart. And so brave. You didn't hear that. You didn't hear shit. You didn't hear fuck, okay? I didn't get distracted right before stream started. You can start stream now? I'm working on it! Thank you! I'm not even on screen yet. It's very kind. What are you doing? We. Huh? Okay, alright. Now we can start. Okay. Listen, fuck watching the fuck I'll sing this whole song. Okay? Because I don't know what that does. Hi, everybody. Welcome to Warp Zone. Nope. Listen, this music's too fucking happy. This music's too happy. Pause. Pause the music. We need to talk about the saddest, sad thing. I need to go on YouTube. We need to talk. Do you understand what is happening today? If you are an Epcot head, you would know this song is not the song I'm looking for. That song's too upbeat. We're not playing the exterior cue music loop. That's not. Listen. If you are an Epcot head, you might know. If you follow my Twitter, you might also know. But for those that don't, today's the last day that Test Track version 2.0 is running at Epcot in Disney World. Epcot like Disney, yes. Test Track 2.0 is the Chevrolet ride where you get inside a weird car that looks strange. And, you go into the Sim Track and you see how good your concept car does. That you made in the pre-show. You go to the pre-show room and you use an iPad. And you use an iPad to design a car, and then you get to see how your car does, and you get to go on a funny little- If they go- Okay, like the land ride? If they fucking close Living at the Land, I commit a crime. Okay, right now, listen, I'm just like being- Like, I'm sad. Like, I'm going to miss Test Track 2.0, and I'm about to explain to you why I'm gonna miss Test Track 2.0 so badly, and then we're gonna play the game about being a funny car. But like, it's straight up, if they close Living at the Land, we're gonna have like a fucking- crisis on this planet. But you're interrupting my memorial. I need sad memorial. Test Track ride ambiance. What does that mean? Is it just gonna be the sound of screaming every 20 seconds during the 60 miles per hour? Oh, it's the outro music. I'm like far away. Yeah, that works. You get in a car that looks like the cover art of your math book. And you ride around in a neon light area. And then you get to see little signs that tell you how good your car did. And I loved Test Track 2.0. And I got to design a bad car at once. I designed a really bad car. It wasn't just me. Me and my sibling did it together. Let me show you my bad car. This car is famous to me. I want this car to be known forever. Swap out image 3. Okay, are you ready? This is the Fuel Frenzy. She has 85 power, 53 responsive, the 72 capability, and you're seeing that right. That's a negative 8 in fuel efficiency. Somehow this car is so bad at fuel efficiency, we've got it to irrational numbers. Do you understand? Also, yes, this was from right before COVID happens. I don't think it was the Fuel Frenzy's fault, but I can't confirm that. This car sucks, and I'm going to miss it forever. And because Test Track 2.0 is closing, I can't use my concept car card in order to see Fuel Frenzy ever again. I even have vacation photos of me and my sibling standing next to the Fuel Frenzy because there's like a photo op that you could do with your fucking car. They're closing Test Track 2.0, and that means they're probably not going to archive the Test Track concept car program. And I found out after printing this card, I'm literally holding the card right now, you can't see it. After printing the card, I found out that you can make a car with -9 stats. That's the max negative number you can hit. And I'm never, ever going to be able to make a -9 car. Because it's closing. I'm never going to be able to make a -9 concept car. And this fucking kills me, chat. And like, it's been all day, and I haven't seen anyone online tweet about like having the concept car program. And there's no way Disney would release it because they hate fun, and they hate families, and they hate me in specific. Otherwise, why would they make Epcot look so bad? If they liked me, Epcot would be better. But they don't like me. They hate me personally. So they're never, ever going to release the concept car program, and I will never be able to make a car as bad as Fuel Frenzy ever again. We need to make our own game where you can make cars. I agree. We need to reverse engineer the concept car program by watching through ride footage and somehow managing to recreate every single option. Do you think maybe if I email Chevrolet, they release it? It's not like Chevy gets a lot of emails, right? Like, who the fuck emails Chevy? Right? Like, I email Disney, they're not gonna respond. Do you think Chevrolet would? Do you see what they did to Small World of Tokyo Disney? You can't say that sentence. That's a really scary sentence. Do you understand how scary that sentence is? No, I don't know. But that's really scary. Because Tokyo Disney's really good. So if they did something bad to it, that would be like hydrogen. That would be like bad. No, you're lying to me. You're lying. This is a trick that you're pulling on me to make me have to cancel the stream because I'm gonna develop a fucking stomach ulcer and die upon seeing that URL. They didn't put Groot in It's a Small World. They didn't. If I don't click on the link, it's not real. And I don't have to accept that that's something that happened. I just don't have to look at it. I just can't look at it. I just can't look at it. I could just sit here. We could just think about the concept car room where you get to design concept cars and then you can take photos of them right next to real Chevrolet cars. We could just think, oh fucking fine, I'm clicking on the link. Fine. Fine. Fandom link. Cool. It's an upcoming. Starring the Guardians of the Galaxy, they'll open in winter 2025 as a 6-month overlay of the original. Sorry, I just kind of threw up a little bit in my mouth. The original, it's a small. No. No. Can't do this. You can't. You can't. You can't do this. That's a Tokyo Disney, see? That's a Tokyo Disney. It's actually a good park. You can't do that. Am I tripping? Or was your bottle always 3D? I've always been in 3D. Hi there. I'm null casting. I'm a 3D creature in your computer. This is fucking scary. Like, listen, I've seen positive, optimistic posting about the test track changes. And, like, really, I'm mostly just sad because we're going to be losing. Like, I just like the vibes of Test Track 2.0, like, a lot. Because it's, like, vapor wavy. I kind of love that, right? Like, it just is. I don't know how else to describe it. I really like it. But people seem excited about the new one, so I just like the concept art that we got. But considering how the last time we got concept art for Epcot went, and they literally- hold on, I need to find this fucking photo. The latest Epcot fucking thing that they just dropped, like, literally looks like a cafeteria. This is not I'm not exaggerating with you. Like, they finally finished their, like, $1 billion- like, they just- I say finished as if they reached their end goal. They gave up on the Epcot overhaul they were doing. It just took down the concrete barriers. And it looks like a fucking high school gym. It looks like a high school gymnasium. It looks like I'm about to have to go and learn how to square dance in there. Did anybody else's high schools make the word square dancing? I later found out that, like, for some reason a bunch of states decided to make their official dance square dancing as a way to combat jazz because they are racist. That's a thing I learned. Browser source window. Uh-huh. All right. So this is the... By the way, they spent, like, so much money on this. Like, it... And this is what they did with it. All right. Cool. The image is just going to be slightly offset. I don't know how to fix that. I would like to formally apologize to the people who managed to get in this Twitter user's photo, even though their faces of despair are really funny. So I'll just kind of block them off with the chat here so we could talk about this. This is literally, like, they spent, like, several billion dollars, and this is what we got. We got this fucking room. Look at this. This shit looks like you're in a mall, and, like this guy right here in the corner, this person right here in the corner of the frame is about to start trying to sell you perfume. So considering that's what we just left off with Epcot, redos. I'm kind of scared about what they're gonna do to my poor test track, even though the concept art looks nice. But, like, there's the Tokyo Disney's actually, like, great design-wise. The idea of them, like, if you're unfamiliar, sorry to any viewers who are here to watch a video game and don't give a shit about theme parks. Tokyo Disney and Tokyo Disney Sea are, like, two of the best, like, theme parks on the planet, because unlike with the American parks and the Paris park, the Imagineers got money and they were allowed to kind of go ham, and so you have all these really beautiful designs and like really well done attractions, and good looking food too. Like, I don't know what's up with that. Like, all the food over there just seems to look better than the slop that they serve here. I maybe there's just a mandate that you're not allowed to have good food in the United States. I wouldn't know. But, like, it's, like, really fucking awesome over there from what I've seen. And it's my goal to go one of these days. But apparently the fucking curse of Marvel, the fucking curse of slapping Marvel on rides, existing rides, if it's going for that park, then we're fucking doomed, right? Like, if not even Tokyo Disney is immune from just random Marvel posting, then we're fucked. Because, like, raise a hand if you've noticed a general consumer lack of caring about Marvel products. I could do that joke, I have a hand tracker. Like, no one wants to fucking watch things about superheroes anymore. There's a million bad superhero movies being released on streaming services every 5 minutes. And you're gonna re-theme a classic ride? To Marvel for 6 months? 6 months. Am I going insane? Is this a bout of lunacy? There's another moon-based joke for all you moonheads out there. Why do we keep doing this? I have heard the Tower of Terror conversion is good. I'm gonna plug my ears and go la 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 because I refuse to believe that ride is good. I know that the Rocket Raccoon animatronic looks amazing, but I refuse to treat to go to different scenes and see wacky characters during the drop where you normally get to see the whole park is better. No, I refuse to believe it. I'm gonna launch the video game now as I keep on yelling about this. Sorry, I'm a hater. I love weird original rides that look like shit and are bad. I like the People Mover the best. Test Track 2.0, I'm gonna miss her so much. There's like a random OnStar fucking ad in the middle of Test Track 2.0 that's like the funniest thing in the world, and we're gonna be losing that. My only exposure to Disneyland at all are those videos about the shitty and failed rides. A good video for understanding my train of thought as the kind of freak I am is Jenny Nicholson's videos about video about the top like 5 boring things to do in Disney World. Because that's kind of how I ride. That's how I feel. Especially because, like, I've been getting better, but I've been kind of a historical wimp. I have been completely incapable for a very long time of even, like, going up ladders. Being in a car that accelerates too fast. Riding a bicycle down a hill. Generally anything that goes too steep or too fast, I get kind of afraid. Or if it goes too high in the air. So it took me a very long time for me to even be able to go on any kind of coaster. So any single other time I went to a theme park of any sort, I was mostly just the bag holder and I didn't really get to do anything fun. So the only things I really got to enjoy were theming and such. So Disney, to me, is the park where there's a bunch of boring rides with a bunch of really interesting theming, especially a bunch of like older ones back from before they were like... that they decided to do everything based on, like, one character for the search engine optimization. And so that's what the park is here for me. So I love the People Mover. I love the weird stage shows. I love older attractions that are actually really good, so I can't even call them boring, but, like, they weren't based on anything in particular. Like, I like It's a Small World. You know, there's, like, 600, like, there's, like, 100, like, uniquely designed like outfits and such in that ride. Like the designer like went and based all these outfits on different cultures on the planet. It's like kind of it's so cool. I love that shit. That's what I'm about. What's your favorite live Disney thing? Besides the People Mover, this is a hard question. It was the Epcot Inventions loop for a very long time. Living with the Land is up there because you get to look at all the beautiful plants and flowers and be inside the nice air-conditioned zone. I'm the only person in my family that likes dinosaurs, so I consider that a lame ride, even though it's like a fast-paced adventure ride, because I'm the only one that can stand how bumpy it is. But it's like in a car and you get a seatbelt, so I feel okay. Or at least I was able to trick my brain for a while to, like, not give a shit about it. Other lame things to do in the parks. The buses. God, I fucking love the buses. I love the inner transit system. The monorails. I'm a freak for the monorails. Basically, just like any of the transit systems. Besides the Skyliner, I'm scared of being up there. I would give anything to ride Interspace or Cranium Command. I would fucking love to ride Cranium Command. I would commit several crimes to go on an original journey to Imagination. Horizons is also up there. I would pay several $100,000 to get a better recording of the vocal theme song for Space Mountain. I wish I could watch Tapestry of Nations in person. That's like my favorite parade. Hi, sorry, I'm like sitting up in my chair all stupid style. Have you ever heard the blog Passport to Dreams? It's tickling a memory in my brain, but I don't recognize it. Hi, also we're playing- I started talking about a test track because we're playing a game about being a weird little car. Does a car that you have to wind up in order for it to go count as negative fuel efficiency? The test track create a car section. That's one of my favorite lame things to do. I fucking love that. Right, okay, the last thing we were doing was we went into the ruined observatory and I decided that it was too late at night for me to start an entirely new. Why are my controls different in that room? Why are my controls different? How do I go back? Okay. It's fucked up every single one of my controls. Every single one of my controls is different. I always find the coolest games. I happen to have been watching a streamer play this for a bit, and then I realized that we had to play it on Warp Zone, and I closed the broadcast. Alternatively, people send them to me, and then I finally get to them, like, 20 years later. Okay, there we go. Now they're back to normal. That was weird. Morio, remind me what you said again. You used to belong to a solitary scientist that come here from time to time. This is where the golden spring of the golden propeller we could see. This is a great place for inspiration. It's the last group that I found turned around and drove me up at the observatory point. Big Thunder was probably one of the first coasters I went on that I didn't cry the entire time during. I think part of the reason why I'm such a wimp is that, like, I was kind of forced into going on to a lot of rides before I was, like, ready for them. Looking at you, Runaway Railroad Ride, and what's it called? Great Adventure. I know, like, I'm sitting here complaining about rides that just have a bunch of characters in them, but I really like PhilharMagic, but, like, to me, that's a lame ride. I really enjoy Muppets 3D Movie. I need to be smart about video gaming. Why am I forgetting every single ride that's ever existed at Disney World? China movie in Epcot. I don't know if that's lame, I just love it. I don't know if I remember the China movie. I mean, I love just going around World Showcase, like, a lot. I have a Hatsune Miku shirt from the Japan Pavilion because I thought it was really funny that it was there. I used to sit and watch the network cast hours in the Innoventions Dream Home. That makes me smile. I have a very early memory of me getting a migraine during the
during like the little like princess dress up thing that they have at Magic Kingdom. And Cinderella kind of got to be like, hey, are you okay? Shout out to that cast member. That was a really nice thing for her too. I don't know where I'm going. That sounds like exactly up my alley. Here's my hottest theme park ride take of the day. There should be one less ride car on Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway. This probably just sounds like gobbledygook to anybody who doesn't know these rides. There used to be a ride called the Great Movie Ride. It was like you go on a ride, big boat seats. Passenger starts to tell you about the movies, and wow, you go into the movies. You see a bunch of animatronics, and the passenger gets attacked at a gang shootout, and then your car gets co-opted by like a gangster. And then the gangster dies in an Indiana Jones set, and you're just supposed to be okay with the fact that they died. And then you finish the ride, and it's cool. And they shut it down, presumably because Turner Classic Movies stopped sponsoring it, I think. And they replaced it with a ride where you're like going into like the new Mickey Mouse cartoons, which is really cute. Except for the fact that, like, hey guys, there's like one too many seats on the fucking ride. Like, there's like four train cars, and they're like, what's it called? They're trackless, meaning that they're basically like big little, like, RC cars that follow radio signals to move around. And there's four of those little RC cars, and the fourth one keeps on. I've ridden the ride twice. Actually, three times, because it broke, and I got to go back there. I got to get a free ride, even though it broke literally right at the fucking end of the ride, so we shouldn't have been allowed to get back on, which is the funniest thing that's ever happened in my entire life. Just, like, sitting there literally right before the unloading station, and then they're like, hey, here's your free fast pass, and it's like, thanks, I did nothing to earn this. But, like, the fourth car routinely gets to scene so late that you see the entire room reset, and you don't actually really get to see the ride. Which is fun, I guess, if you've seen the ride 18 times. But, man, that experience sucks if you, say, have never seen the ride before. It also has, like, a 4-hour queue line, because it's the newest ride. Cough, cough. Anyway, I just don't understand why it has so many, seats. I guess just for capacity reasons. Whoa! The behind-the-scenes car. It is even, like, it's, like, just, like, weirdly timed. So you just, like, the whole illusion of the ride gets broken, and not in, like, a fun and cool way. It just kind of feels like, oh, these scenes are just on a timer. They're not reacting to the cars being present in the scene at all. Like, you'd think that they'd time it out a bit this way, like, you wouldn't be able to see that, but I guess they didn't care or didn't have time to fix that or didn't notice it during testing. All of which are bad signs for a company with more money than some countries. I'm sure it's fine, though. I'm sure the test track reconstruction will go great, and we have nothing to worry about. A strange color. Take a look. Did they cover the moon in oil? I'm so hungover and tired today. Get yourself some water and get yourself some salt so that way the electrolytes in the water work better. It's fucking green. I'm supposed to do something on that screen. We're just gonna hang out here for a bit and see if anything happens. I did manage to write up a good thought summary for my game. That is awesome and great news. I am supposed to be working on a pitch deck, and I haven't really started it yet. And I need to start it this week, like, now. Which is, you know, stressful. Okay, moon's green. That's generally bad news. We generally don't want to see that. What are we supposed to do over here? Are we just collecting enough gears to... I don't know. Oh, I guess there is. That's cool. Alright, I need to be running into those. Sometimes those have gears in them. We need more gears. I think we're probably gonna have to hit 90 to access the next level. Oh, hey, there's one right there. Okay. Another favorite lame thing to do in this world. The Jungle Cruise Thai-in Cafe. They have like some really good like noodles and stuff, and they add like topping both of them. And I think this adds like fun texture. Eh? Clunk clunk. Facial recognition now running. Access denied. Someone has not come back yet. Oh, that's probably the get every rabbit check, huh? If I had to take like a gander, if I had to take a wee little guess. Considering all the rabbits that are everywhere in this level, that's probably the purpose of that door. Okay. There's a gear up there somewhere. Oh, it's right there, okay. Opinions on the new Doctor Who series. I've only seen some of the episodes. My sibling is more of the big Doctor Who head compared to me. I think it's cute and fun. I don't understand the focus on music if they're not even gonna have funny songs all the time, excluding hit song My Dog by the Beatles. That one's pretty slapper. Classic for the ages. Beatles episode all around is very funny. I liked it. 73 Yards, also really interesting. The other ones I don't remember having any opinions on one way or the other. Mostly I'm just there as emotional support for my sibling, whose special interest is Doctor Who. So if the show goes bad, I have to be like, it's gonna be okay. And if the episode's good, then we can pog. At the very least, this is a good level to get coins at. Although I wonder where the other gears are.
Every
Everything will be okay.
Just like that. I want to see what that is, actually. Instead of just being a rabbit, I guess. Old man passing by off screen, very scary. I'm scared. Who else is scared? Okay, I guess we're going back to Mario's lab and going back into his mind level, his mind palace, in order to get other gears. I don't know where the last one is. Other lame things to do at the parks. I'm still thinking about that, by the way. You can also go back into other levels that had orange button panels, because we unlocked all the orange buttons. Oh! Hello, Alien Mario. Oh, that was almost so sick. The dinner, the dessert events for the fireworks shows are lame as hell, and I love them because you get treats. You get themed treats. Sometimes the theming's good. Most of the time, the theming is fucking stupid. But you get little desserts, and you get to sit. If you do the one in Magic Kingdom, you get to sit in the Tomorrowland Terrace, which I love because it's in Tomorrowland. Ooh, favorite lame thing, Sunny Eclipse. I love listening to his robot performances. The non-inclined, he's like, what's it called? He's like an animatronic that does little song performances at like a space-themed food quick service area. And he sings about his ex-wife. And about how he has backup singers that are completely invisible, and that's lore, that's canon lore, it's not just because they can't afford another set of animatronics, that's lore. And I love him, he's my favorite. They should make a really dark and depressing movie about Sunny Eclipse. There's a gear. How do I get up there, though? Get back on the platform. No, I called my death. I was listening to a Terror podcast about Sunny earlier today. That's so poggers. Wait, no, it isn't his ex-life, it's his mother-in-law. He just really hates his- right? I'm trying to remember the- Although, considering how many jokes he makes about his mother-in-law, maybe it's also about his ex-wife. Gear. Okay, I just like completely button lagged there and couldn't do my awesome jump. I can do this. I could do that jump. I could do that jump and we could get that gear. All right, right, cool. Cool. Cool that the buttons do. It's because I moved too far away from the zone and it switches my inputs. That's why that's happening to me. Because over here is the camera flip zone. So if I move out of that area before starting my flip of wheel, it fucks up. The fact that the camera, like the way that you control switches in between areas is honestly the worst thing about this game. This game is really awesome, except for that. How did I almost get it that one time and now we're just gonna be stuck here forever? Make that jump. I think that's an optical illusion. I think that's a trick of the light. I'm gonna try again though. Who needs money? I can't make that jump. It's a lie. It's literally lying to me. It's a lie. It's fake. It's fake. It's fake jump. It's fake jump. It's not real. More do I need to get? 130! You're having a laugh, mate, at my expense. Screws and bolts for those lasagna you made are terrible. Don't worry, I misquit your soul, whatever you do, it's love that moves everything. Oh, there's Mario Lord out here.
Time extended!
Shit.
My beloved creature, right how you show up, right how you teach me. My beloved creature, bro. Mario has deep-seated anxieties. Yeah, it definitely seems like it. Actually, maybe I don't want to do this. Go back to the lab. We're gonna go back to other levels that had orange boxes in them because, fuck that. Tesla offices have orange boxes in it. I don't remember.
some orange. No, not in this level. Exit. Exit. 130? That's 40 more gears to access the next level. Welcome to the simulation room. The simulatron lets you create yourself inside a super complex simulation. Child simulator goes for called fake gears. Okay, that's the sad trial zone. What is pizza time? The pizza time already orange? I mean, the whole level's orange, but like. I know Bomb Beach had. Yes! Shit, right, I need to do jobs in this one. Also, gear on top of that building. Get up there. Oh, he's just gonna be walking into that door forever, huh? I guess that's good. That means he isn't gonna get eaten. Okay, we need to do a job. Come back to that. Or maybe I'll fuck up the jump and I won't be able to get that gear, even though I could have gotten that gear right then. Everybody in this universe has cars and funny horns. Ah! Oh, it was that easy. Okay, cool.
What was that?
not here. Where is it though? Is it up there? No. Where is it though?
Time extended.
I mean, that was cool, but I don't think that helped at all.
Extended.
Ears? Ears for me? Anywhere?
Wait, no, Arcade Panic had like an entire area with the orange boxes.
Get that. I wonder how I get up there to get that other gear.
Thank you.
just not do this area right last time at all? Miss. Somehow that worked. Okay, I need to not just flip a wheel off of ledges. Get up there either. Arcade Panic continues to be a level that confuses me dearly. I'm in this level, but I don't know how to get up there, which is where I would assume more would be. Bomb Beach it is. can use the bomb to platform onto that thing and then get up.
Time extended.
Like that. That's another one. Cog, champ. You're now hitting the problem in collectathons that I always run into because I'm bad at doing things in video games consistently, where I have to suddenly go back and find all the areas where I just kind of gave up on getting anything done and do them. That famous secret cave, my car turns over to a bomb, also the cave is under the sea, and my stomach is full of air. I would float. Can you take me underwater?
Go, go, go!
I don't think I was in here. Cave at all. I don't like being outdoors, am I right? By the way, there's a shining green thing over there. Be careful. Thanks, buddy.
Time extended.
I didn't mean to hit it. Oh, it didn't hit. It just hit the monster. Okay, we're fine. I'm not a blue monster today. I'm bruised. Hi. Just kidding. Got my helmet. I can talk normally. Oh, okay. Bye. There's some gears in those floating bombs, but I don't want to have to deal with that, because that means I'd have to hit a bomb into it, and that's like effort and energy. Right now, all I want to do is look for more orange things. Is there a gear over there? Do you know where any other green things are? Over there. I don't get over there though.
Time extended.
Why am I down here?
Time extended.
Play Road Trip Adventure again really badly. Would you guys want to watch me do another Charo game? Please say yes.
Time extended.
Nice. How'd I get here? How do I get down? So for you. Is that that PS2 game? Yes, it is that PS2 game. It's THE PS2 game to me, though. So, do the orange things just let you get cash in the rabbit? How do I get up there? absolutely love that. Yes. 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 It's like, this just makes me miss Road to Adventure a little bit. Like, you were a little funny car with weird physics. But in that game, I got to become the president. I don't know what just happened to my physics there, but it's awesome. Underwater coins, that's right. Hi, Data. I am gonna be missing coins because coins don't matter. So, just get emotionally prepared for that. We already have the funniest hat in the whole game. What need do we have any more hats? Coins. Just Jonathan. We need to get 24 more of these stupid green fucks. How in the goddamn hell are we going to do that? One left of Mario's home, one left of your tunnels. I guess Granny's Island has a bunch. Morizio City. Crash Test Industries has a million, actually. Oops. Jont cares about the coins, so I don't have to. If I could do like a, like, if I could just open my mouth and play like the Nostalgia Critic theme music, I would, but I don't know how to do that. We have to go back to Morizio City and Granny's Island, which I want to go to first because I want to see if there's been any changes. Hey, Rover! Do you have anything new to say down here? Final destination, Tossus HQ. Okay, where he goes to. Hurry up and collect all the gears necessary to open the portal. Okay. Yeah, we're almost done with the game then. Fuck. I wouldn't get any Nostalgia Critic jokes anyway, it's okay. Back when I was really young, I used to watch his videos and enjoy them. Then I grew older and I started to put it bluntly, understand media. And then I couldn't stand the YouTube channel. And then the whole change the channel thing happened that I really couldn't stand the channel. And then some time ago, I learned about his wall review. And I've been baffled ever since. Bat credit card. The thing is that a bat credit card is funny and great. That's so awesome. Like, that's such a funny idea. And the fact that he hates it is because he sucks at his brain. Whoa. Sorry. Oh my god, that's a fucking alligator. Car-a-gator. Gator car? You mean to tell me? Gave him a bat credit card? Hey, ain't that that movie? Get ready. Go. Hi. He's in every single fucking level, and honestly, if I were the creators of this game, I would have made it so that he has a very slight change on how he says it in every level. Like reference to any gorillas. Real or fictional. Like I would have done that every level. That would have been so funny. Ow! The music down here fucking bangs. Sorry, can you talk to me? I finally found them. Time for breakfast. Eh? Bones? Oh, I guess bones. Sorry. Has anyone else been concerned about the dinosaur bones down here? Is that just like a me problem? Left first. You gotta save it for the this level really happened though bit. That is a good bit. Hi, man. Skeletons love to be stylish and cool. They are hit. Oh. Thanks. Down?
Time extended. Time extended.
Wait, skeleton hat. Fuck. Sorry, I think I died. Okay, that just brings me back up here. With no time left. Very cool. Oh, this guy's probably gonna want to ride, and I'm not gonna know where to bring him. What's your joke? People can tell when a skeleton lies. They are bad liars, as everyone can see right through them.
Go, go, go!
Down? Get that skeleton guy down there. Now.
Time extended. Time extended. Time extended.
The skeleton guy I lost to the stratosphere outside the map now. Before we entered the zone. Cracks a laugh. Okay, man. There's so many skeleton men down here. Skeletons are so fun because no one gets under their skin. It's okay. If I explode the car, I get to not do the Uber drive. Skeleton passengers are fated to plunge into the hole. It's because I don't know where to fucking bring them.
Extended.
hard for a trip to your rave. I don't have enough energy to sit in the skeleton rave. Fuck. I don't have the guts. Okay. Down! I just came from down. Teeth grinding noises. All right, man.
I'm extended. I'm extended.
All right, it's up that way, right? Wait, no, I need to move somebody else so I can get enough health. Fuck! I'm pretty sure it's the trombone. Give me more power, you hacks. I didn't mean to do that. Climbing the sewers fucking sucks. This guy's health is ticking down so fast, means he must be relatively close by. Going the right way.
The gentlemen can watch while I'm scrubbing the floors and unscrubbing the floors while you're gone. And that
maybe average to your taxi ride. Yeah. Swell
in a ratty water in a ratty old hotel. And they Yahweh never adjust to who you're talking. You never adjust to who you're talking.
Yeah?
Suddenly one night, there's a scream in the night and you wonder, what could that have been? And you see me kind of grinning while I'm scrubbing.
You see me kind of grinning while I'm scrubbing.
What you got to grin?
There's such a rhythm to that line. You see me kind of grinning while I'm scrubbing.
A blast. But the skull,
I need to get back to the skeleton rave room. Everything I'm doing is in service of getting back to the skeleton rave room. Rave room had more stuff next to it that I didn't get to see because I died.
Time extended.
Fine.
make the sewers less painful. But I don't think... I don't know. You listen, as a game developer, you win some, you lose some. The slime is losing me some. The slime level... I think is a bit of a... Maybe that's why it's behind the orange thing, all the way in the corner of the map. You don't love slime? I mean, like, I enjoy a slime, but mechanically, this is a fucking nightmare. I'm having a goddamn fucking shithole of a time trying to get up. It's like jump, you have to slide up, and then the water's pushing you down. It sucks. Oh. But I gotta do it. I gotta dump this client. Sorry, bud. I have to reset my time. Oh my god, I'm all the way back fucking here. Okay.
Time extended. Time extended.
What the fuck? Oh, that's why it sucks so bad. I wasn't supposed to go this way. I wasn't supposed to do that, ever. That's why it sucks. But guys, that's why it sucks. That's... You get there... A different way. I need to exit flushed away before I start biting at the walls. I can't. We have to leave the area. We have to leave right now. We need to go back and get 10 gears in Granny's Island. Cause I was going up the fucking ramp the wrong way. It was just a different... Such an idiot! No wonder it sucks so bad. I wasn't supposed to be doing that. I'm sitting here complaining about the game, but I'm like doing it backwards. I'm like, why does every piece fit in the square hole? Better than that, but clearly I'm not. Plant man. I don't remember what his skill is. that a normal car?
Hey King, they're saying not to use our cars. Why is that? Well, time for me to trade my legs. I knew this day would come. Anyway, I'm a fucking moron and a fool. And, John, make sure to leave a note in the fucking- if you ever edit this into a stream, people are gonna start getting mad before they get to the firm and realize I'm being an idiot. What's her getting up here? With your moveset, there's no place you cannot reach. Oh, hello, Nick of Will. Sorry for being mean about your game for a few minutes there. I assume you're the developer. So doable. There's never been anything more doable ever in the history of video games. Not like that though. Not like that either. Not like that either. How did I do it the first time? Not like that. Ah! The peaceful music is offsetting by my extreme gamer panic. Go so fast. Okay. I wish I could make a save state right here. That's the one thing I would like to ask for this game. Please add save states. I'm gonna get this. I don't care if this takes the rest, the next 20 minutes of stream. I'm getting this gear. I won't feel good until I get it. The Granny's Island music is like so poggers. So poggers and serene. Okay. Wow, 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 wow. No, 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 no! Okay, it's fine, we're fine, we're fine, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine. How is everybody else's Sunday going? I need to not hit the top of that on my ascent upwards. I need to like jump off the side of it. Eepy, as they say. So true. After this, I think I'm gonna go make myself a little treat, a little dessert. And then I think I might chillax! What did I tell you? Totally backwards log jump off the top of that thing to get to that other gear. But that's still one more gear, which is good. There's a gear on that ledge. I'm only seeing it from far away. Oh wait, this is where I am. Well, that's a cool way to get back up here. Not what I intended to do, though. It's not green over there. I've gotten the thing that's down here, right? I've gotten the one that's down here. I missed a point now. Good and cool me. Yeah, I got that. Okay. Oh, I did beat Liza P the other day. Nice! I've never heard of that. What is it? P and what are their falsehoods? Up over there, I see another one. Pinocchio, true. Wait, oh, for real? Why is it? That's kind of a baller fucking name. Souls like fairy? That's cool! Oh! Do I need to have the swirly, fucking twirly bullshit thing for that?
I just needed to be good at the game. I just need to get good. Now let's go in the orange zone. Oh, it's my compulsory girlfriend. Hello, I'm so glad to see you. If you want to spend some time here, prepare a minigame timing just for you. The heavy play will be different, remember, no jumping. Okay. No canceling for the world. Nebulous, a European town in the middle of a robot rising and zombie plague, and it's delay! The world's fair! I'm gonna hear everyone play again, just restart and try to restore them. Dude, me. Why is it in reverse? That's scary! I'm scared! I'm fucking scared myself! Why is it reversed? Why is it fucking reversed? That's scary! This is not the level I intended to enter, but let's go say hi.
Watch
to the
out.
Funny gorilla.
You're gonna crash! Ah!
Ah! Thank you. Are there time ups in this? Okay.
Time extended.
Alright, because I'm looking for orange. Wisdom be out for this time, man. The eye of these. Actually stand to make the most progress in 6 minutes is not that level. It's in the Crusher Factory, which I basically just sprinted through. This one. Crash test. Basically just sprinted through those fucking levels. Look at the orange box. I really wanted to play Team Fortress. That's your joke for the episode. Right, that? Did I have to check out the hats in this level? Yeah, so it's just crushers and smashers and bashers and all that. This is why I need so much of Deathstroke! You're up there. How do I get up there, though? So I can't cancel if I jump to this level. I have a feeling that we're not gonna solve the problem by the end of the broadcast. Ramp maybe? I'm trying! Goodbye, yellow car. Fuck! We can get that one before the end of the level. I mean, end of the stream. This is probably a bad time to admit that I have issues with depth perception. This is gonna drive me crazy. We need to get this gear before the stream ends. Ah! start biting my fucking controller to pieces. It's been a means, by the way. Actions on that. How does moderator view even fucking work? Man! That was awesome. Okay. Anyway, we're leaving. We're leaving. We're leaving. Listen, we're gonna try to beat the game next stream. I'm enjoying Yellow Taxi Ghost Room, but I'm worried that... How does that keep on happening without anybody even doing the sound alert? That's really scary. After this, by the way, guess what's next? You don't have to guess. We're having Sonic Adventure Summer. We're doing Sonic Adventure Summer. I need you to, after we beat this game, I need you right now, you the viewer, yes you, to go onto the Discord and tell me if we should start from the beginning of Sonic Adventure 1, beat Sonic Adventure 1, and then do all of Sonic Adventure 2? Or just say, don't do them in order? I kind of want to do them in order, but I want to hear people's thoughts on the matter. This is- I already said this is scary, right? I need to re-emphasize that this is scary. Like, this is very scary and scary. Anyway, lots of streams on this channel. You should go watch all of them. I'm trying to watch all the new streams that are happening now. I'm trying to get better about that.
Everything will be okay.
Who did that? How did that happen about me even seeing the stream alert? That's scary. I don't know. Might not be streaming for me on Wednesday again. Going forward, just like... So I was just testing all the sound alerts to fuck with me. That's cool. Just assume Wednesdays probably aren't gonna happen unless a secret awesome surprise happens. Just because my schedule's fucked. Other people's schedules, check the Discord. And with that, does anyone have anyone we should raid? Okay, I can see that at the very least. Boxing Puppy is here.
I love this show!
Anyone at all? Anyone at all for raiding? Power Up with Pride is playing Shadow of the Colossus. That's the game where there's a bunch of big guys that you have to go attack and you're small, right? That's cool. I'll send you guys that way. Well, you should talk about being a little car.
Born too late to explore the Earth. Born too early
doing fucking broadcast
Born
tests.
Born just in time to spam memes.
Alright. Have a good one, y'all. I'll see you later.